So I've been talking about housekeeping, whether there's food, there will be enough food for the whole day, we will have a party sponsored by Ocean Protocol tonight, which is very fortunate, I'm very happy about that. There's one problem, so I had two students who wanted to look after the presentations, I'm happy with it, but they canceled, they called in sick this morning, so we have to like work on the presentations our own a little bit. And, but it's very easy, you can send it, it's like on the program page all the way down to the bottom, and to the people that come, I would appreciate if you tell them, and there shouldn't be much work, right? Because you can just send your talk to talks@blockchainforscience.com, or upload it to the Dropbox, and it will be on the presentation computer here over here right away, yeah? So we don't need to have a big presentation system and everything else, right? It should be easy. You can have PDF, Keynote, PowerPoint, Google Drive, Google Presentations, everything, okay? Okay, and I'm very happy that you are all here, and I'm very excited about this. And this is the second international conference on blockchain for science, and thank you for coming, including those who traveled far. Like last year, people traveled from overseas, from Australia, and this year again, and it's like really cool. It's really an international conference, and thank you very much for you all being here, taking the effort to like gather on this very important topic. And so last year's conference was a success. There were some 120 people were there, some people got to know each other, projects were initiated, a cooperation started, and I want to have this year again. And in the program, there's more time for networking and hacking and socializing than last year. And this is like, especially because it's important. You can also have so and so many frontal talks, and what's important is that you work together. So what happened in the last year in Blockchain for Science? Well, after the conference, there was another conference, ZEED, organized by Validity Labs in Davos, on blockchain topics in research, and we had a meetup together with Molecule and the Weizenbaum Institute and Blockchain Nights and during the Berlin Blockchain Week, and I want to thank the participants for that on science funding. And we saw that the blockchain field, so overall blockchain field, but also the blockchain in science field moved from ICO-driven projects to, and the unlasting crypto winter to like really working projects that actually moved to alpha version, even better versions that became serious. Legal structures were funded for these projects. And we are like, I think in German we say we divide the Spreu from the Weizen. Yeah, and it's actually happening, so it's a good sign. So the conference this year's and last year's conference was criticized. It was criticized on many levels, behind the scenes and up front, right? So, well, I don't want to go into things here, but the field has to mature, and this is for sure, right? And this needs a lot of work, and we have to, it should not be a centralized entity that does all this stuff. It also by itself has to decentralize, right? And, well, in terms of conference organization and stuff, we keep things easy here. If you think about like a conference I was invited to, like a four-letter engineers conference in Berlin on like bioengineering, they had like you basically go there as an invited speaker, you pay 1,100 euro, and you go through a very outdated online submission system, and you actually sign away all your copyrights on everything that you have. You go to LaTeX and everything. It takes you like 1 hour or 1.5 hours to submit stuff. And you pay 1,100 and you get a coffee and the apple, right, during the conference, right? So there's a lot of overhead going on. And we keep these things simple, and the Blockchain for Science conference will always be like this, right? So, and what is the fundamental idea of us doing all this stuff? Well, Blockchain for Science. So I have to openly disclose to you that we are basically doing an ICO. Yeah, we want to collect $40 million upfront and build the infrastructure of science for the future. Of course, this was just a joke, right? So we don't do an ICO or something, right? Well, we do one, an initial sticker offering, and you have your fungible or non-fungible token, and you can discuss about that the whole day or the whole next 2 days, whether a real world sticker is fungible or non-fungible. And and we don't do an ICO for sure. People ask me, like, what is the business model behind Blockchain for Science and the Limited and stuff? Well, it's basically there to organize conference and bring people together to bridge worlds, right? But to bridge the world between the crazy blockchain scene, with their crazy ideas and things, sometimes too crazy people, right? And with a science world. The conservative science world, sometimes too conservative science world, right? And there are a lot of Berührungsängste sometimes. Like between people that live in Neukölln and maybe Charlottenburg, you know? There are like prejudges and misconceptions. And basically the idea of Blockchain for Science is to bridge these both worlds and bring them together, yeah? So what are the challenges in the current process of this? And we have like several challenges here. So, of course, there are misconceptions of what blockchain actually is. And I wrote to like ministries or to like institutes, and they said like, oh, we don't do blockchain here because of Greta and Friday for Futures. We don't want the energy conception. And well, blockchain can't contain enough data. It's not good for anything. And you have to double your data and everything. It's a lot of waste of resources. And blah, 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 you all heard these things. And we know better, and we can argue with them, and this is our task to like bring this out into the world and like inform people and enable them to make informed decision about what blockchain really is, right? And that it's not only a hype, there is some hype component, but hype is only good, it's also good, it brings stuff or brings energy to the field, right? And then I heard the well-uttered skepticism from established groups about and very focused research groups. Yeah, well, we already had decentralized and distributed systems in ages. Blockchain is nothing new, and even systems that can like be proved and provably do stuff to the outside. So what, this blockchain is all stupid stuff, right? We don't need that. We all have been there. It's like a hype of crypto kitties or whatever. And it's like, they have a point. From a technical perspective, they have certainly a point. But if you would like transfer the same argument to Facebook, then you can see Facebook as just a database and your timeline as just a query of a database, right? You would miss completely the point of what the Web 2.0 means to us. Technically, it's just a database, a connected database, right? And technically, blockchain is just a distributed database in the system, but people arguing this way totally miss a point on what the crypto economy, the no token structures, the new token structures, and token and incentive system could mean, or what the new deals on data, on privacy could mean, right? And what they are missing is that blockchain and the hype enables people to like talk about new user autonomy. They maintain their own power, their own crypto wallets, right? And even as bad as Facebook or Libra might look like, but like this pressure brings us to this to enable a lot of people to have a wallet, to be able to keep maintain their own keys. So also researchers to do that in the future, right? So this is a good thing of this. And then another funny argument that I heard was, blockchain, I heard it from a friend who was a computer scientist, and blockchain is just a way to timestamp data in a decentralized manner, right? And he's right with it. He's as right as saying, the internet is just a way to send around bits and bytes, right? And I totally agree with him, but he's totally missing the point again. Or if I keep sending like the request Blockchain for Science and this email is forwarded to the IT department, not the IT department that develops those new computer systems or something, but the IT department that maintains the firewall, right? So it's just forwarded to the people to like talk about computer security. And they're missing the point too, right? And then another thing that might hinder us to bring blockchain to the research world is that blockchain can question things that research institutes do at the moment. And there are a lot of people in research, stakeholders, that work on basically maintaining, accounting, administration and everything. And we know that blockchain can potentially complement these things. So they might be afraid as much as banks are afraid of the crypto euro or something, okay? So what is Blockchain for Science? Blockchain for Science is basically a passport toto name for all Web3 in science and research. And we have to communicate this and bring this out to the scientists and the researchers, all these things, and like deal with the misconceptions. So the positive things on bridging these worlds is that many things happened that are very good. So established institutes moved into the field blockchain. And I'm very happy that we have some of them here. Companies, serious companies with like backing, with a past track history of providing really good services to the science community, communication community. Some of them are here and helping the conference. And they are like moving into the field. Grants has been giving to research groups on investigating blockchain for research. So we moved away from this like craze and we learned, yeah? And if we talk about this, well, the name of the conference is New Deals, so New Deals on science funding, on innovation, on data. We talk about new systems. And we should not forget that our old systems have drawbacks too, but we are just very used to them, right? So our current science system has a token economy, so to say, around the impact factor and stuff. And if we design and talk about new systems, we shouldn't be so strict, yeah, with them. And we should like tell the things that are good about them and just like see that our old systems also have drawbacks, yeah? And okay, so when we are here talking about the old system, I don't want to, and I'm like kind of done with talking about like how bad the publishers are, how greedy Elsevier is, how like double-edged sword the open access movement is, how conservative librarians are and all this stuff, right? We here shouldn't make the existing system look as bad as possible because we can like provide so many good things and novel systems and interesting things that we can like look forward and just leave the old system behind and to leave it to other people to make the old system look back, right? And I'm like kind of like, we know this, there are like people having their career in this field, working in this field, like in the old mindsets and everything, and this is okay and we have to respect that. Because Blockchain for Science has to like work with them and adapt with them and with these structures, right? And we are just amending the system, complementing it on the longer term. Okay, I already said this. And so what is going to happen with this conference, with the Blockchain for Science community? Basically, we have to move forward at some point. Like decentralized, as I already said, like, but we also should stay independent and trustworthy to discuss things, like trustworthy from the tempting structures of or for the temptation of traditional structures, being a grants authority, salaries, reputation system, and as much as possible. And this will be a long process. And skepticism has never moved anything forward, right? And I want to conclude with my, so to say, introduction and move over to housekeeping now. Are there any questions on this, like urgent ones? Okay, so regarding the housekeeping, I want to like withdraw after this introduction. I want to participate in the communication and discussion as any one of you does. I don't want to introduce yourself. I don't want to introduce you. You introduce yourself, okay? Two students like called in sick today, so we have to do all the presentations and this work around this. I already told you it's on the webpage. Ourselves, and please stick to the talking time. There's a counter, and the talking time is including question and answers. So if you overdo it, there will be no discussion right after your talk, right? If you want to leave some time after the talk, you can do that, right? You just have a shorter talk. And sorry for the badges. Some of the most important participants didn't get badges. This was like a problem in our workflow, and I have to apologize for that. Didn't get pre-printed badges. And okay, so please allow me personal remarks. Yeah? Many visionaries and people I have worked with have great ideas and were very supportive in the beginning to talk about blockchain for science and the potential of decentralization in research. And the same, but also the same, I work with visionaries, and maybe some part I'm a visionary myself in like basic medical imaging sciences and everything. But these people sometimes have some other characteristics, right? So they sometimes don't integrate with more down-to-earth people, and they have communication problems. They are not as streamlined as other people. And they don't give a shit about some hierarchical structures like walking up the, like climbing up the ladder and stuff. And I think our science culture has one problem, because it's not supporting these people that are especially important. Those early ideas giver, these odd birds, the strange people, and we really should have the value deposition of some stuff at these people. Right, and I think the current incentive structures in science and research basically support the people that are administrators of the current system, of the current structures, and not the odd birds that give new ideas. Even if an idea, ideas are very important, really new ideas are very important, because some people say like implementation count. I think that's wrong. What counts are really, and those people never had really good new ideas, right? So it's for business point of view, this might be the case. But, and my personal motivation of like doing all this stuff is that I think the upcoming crypto economy and token economies and novel incentive structures around that could potentially create an environment in which we could like support innovators, crazy people, better than we do it today. And that's basically bringing me to the first topic. It's a crypto economy. And we start with Paul Kohlhaas from Molecule, with talking about blockchain for science funding. Thank you very much. And last but not least, have fun here too, okay? Yeah, okay, thank you.